Welcome. Let's talk about what was the news yesterday. It's the HECI, or the HECI, that's the Higher Education Commission of India. Now, this has come into line with the repeal of the UGC Act that was established in 1956, and we are planning to bring this new Higher Education Commission of India, or this act, under the monsoon session in 2018. The idea is, by 7th July, we have a kind of draft that is already ready, and you have numerous people who have been asked for the feedback at the reforms of UGC at gmail.com. So the idea is to bring in more and more ideas for the new body that is to be established. So far, what have been the important developments that have taken place in higher education? In line to those developments, we have this new commission that has been established, or that is being proposed. So far, we have brought in reforms in NAC. We have already discussed NAC in a separate lecture. Regulation of grant for graded autonomy of the universities. Granting of the autonomous estates to the college. We already have the list of autonomous universities this year. So that's again very, very important. Regulation for the open distance learning and regulation for the online degrees. So those have been done so far. Now we are talking about the Higher Education Commission of India Act 2018 that we would be discussing now. Now, why this has been brought into light? There are five important reasons for it, and those are the sole idea around which this new commission has been proposed. First is to bring an end to the Inspector Raj. So that's the very obvious reason why we have a new body, similar to we had for the NEET Aayog. The next is separation of grant funds. Now, this new body would focus exclusively on academic matters. We are planning to have less government and more governance. So that has been the idea of government for, let's say, all other services as well. The focus on academic quality and powers to reinforce. Now, all these we would be discussing on the individual focus areas as we move forward. So why we are bringing this new commission? We are trying to bring in more autonomy to the colleges and universities. We are trying to basically create a holistic development, make education more affordable, bring in foreign investments, make better administrations. No interference of the management with the educational institute is another very, very important aspect. Then under the powers to enforce, we are trying about regulating the transparent public disclosure systems, regulating the opening and closing of an educational institution, checking the standards of the educational institution. So substandard educational institutions should be closed down, enforcing the compliance in the academic level. So those are some of the important ideas, and again putting a penalty or a fine on the institutions that do not comply with the academic standards. Now, what is the proposed composition? So it's a kind of 12 member panel that is being proposed, along with a chairman and a vice chairperson and a vice chairperson. The age limit for those would be 70 years. The members would be there for 5 years duration. These 12 members would be 3 from the government, central government. So those could be from the Secretary of Higher Education, Secretary of Ministry of Skill Development, and so on. 2 chairpersons from the other regulatory bodies of education, let's say AICTE, NCTE. So NCTE and AICTE are not being subsumed under, or have not been repealed under this. So they are still there. The next is 2 chairpersons of the Executive Council, 2 serving vice chancellors of the universities, 2 serving professors of the universities, and 1 from industry. So those would be the composition of these 12 members. Again, they would be scholars in their own field. So they would be scholars of eminence, having leadership quality and proven capacities in the various institutions they are working with. The highlights of this HECI bill, or the HECI Act, basically talks about improving the academic standards, providing a roadmap for mentoring the various institutions, having powers to enforce, as we talked about previously, trying to grant authorization to start any academic operation, closure of the institution if they fail to adhere to the norms, formulate a code of good practice. That's again important, and this code of good practice would be for promotion of research, teaching and learning in the institution. we would have a kind of penal provisions which would cover the withdrawal of the power of grants or degrees or diplomas. We would have an advisory council which would help us advise to the method of coordination and determination of the standards, monitoring through a national database. So that's again very, very important. So all the emerging new fields of ideas and knowledge would be monitored through a national database, and we would have norms for fixing the fees which is chargeable by higher education institutions, so making higher education more affordable to the students. So those are the key aspects that have been proposed. So since it would be a kind of affordable quality education, the students would have definitely a better edge with the new commission that would be up. So do expect some positive whips from here. Stay tuned for more updates. Have a great day ahead.